Get ready to match the stars. Avery Schreiber, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Nancy Kulp, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Bulifant as we play in the star-studded Big Bunny Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Reber.
Hi, John Nelson. How are you?
Good.
Thank you.
That's a lively bunch, and we hope you're feeling lively, too, today. And if you're not feeling lively, these people will liven up your day.
No, no.
There, oh, what was that?
I could do that.
Yeah, yeah.
I wouldn't mind it.
I wish you'd say something funny.
Oh, there he is.
Hello.
Are you ready? Good.
Yes, of course. For what?
Well, I think we ought to remove the dry cleaning.
The dry cleaning tag
should be tucked
very
in.
Cruel of
that's
you.
Right.
That's what I thought. She has a screw loose.
Well, at least I have it.
That's right.
Now, let's now say what will I do with it, Richard?
Paula Miller and Mildred all red there. These two ladies are very matched all six celebrities on one question, didn't you? Now, she's a current champ. She's got $5,600, and she's being challenged by a very able game player, Mildred Allred.
Thank you.
From, I've forgotten where you're from.
Ventura,
right. You own that big freeway, don't you? Yes.
Wish I did.
You do. All right, now, we'll tell you what happens when we have a tiebreaker question in a moment or so, but right now, we've got this for you. Ready?
Oh, it is.
Here we go. I'll blow the fuse here and get rid of the lights and push this button. Reveal one tie-breaking question for each of you ladies, and the one who's matched the most celebrities will be the winner. Mildred, you may have A or B.
A, please.
A. She's been sticking with A because that's A for all.
Problem.
You have a problem? That's what everybody keeps saying.
It's raining all over my box here.
What? Yeah, look at all that stuff.
I don't know what it is, and every time I look down at my notes, it's got a wet on it.
Really?
They oiled the fan.
They oiled the fan?
Could I have an umbrella, please?
Yes.
What?
It is.
Oh, no, there's
I
a
know.
Dog up
it's
there.
Terrible.
It's not paper trash.
Yes. You want to sit over there?
Why?
Okay.
She wishes she had
sit right over there.
That.
Okay, right. I'll sit here. All right, here we go. At Consumer Reports, Herman said, things really worked out well at the office today. All morning long, we tested beer. Then all afternoon, we tested blank. I'm watching. All right. Okay.
Oh, wait a minute.
All right. We'll figure out what that is, Joyce. We don't want you to be uncomfortable.
It's very dramatic, though.
Yes, it is.
Yes. I think it's exciting.
All right, here we go, Mildred. At Consumer Reports, Herman said, things really worked out well at the office today. All morning long, we tested beer. Then all afternoon, we tested blank.
Our kidneys. You drink a lot of beer, you will.
She said our kidneys. Well... That's very good.
Well, it's...
I don't know if these people are going to be that logical.
It's clinical.
Yes, it is clinical. What do you say, Avery?
Well, I got a little more specific.
What do you
mean,
say?
I mean, a little more general. The John.
The John.
No good, though, babe.
No, that's not it. What do you say? She's looking for a
kidney. You've got to have them before you can test them, don't you?
Right.
Well, I said the lady and gentleman's toy.
Okay.
But that's not a match,
no, it isn't. We're looking for kidneys
well,
here, one or two.
I think it's snowing over my seat.
That's because you're higher up.
Burps. We tested burps. Well, Mildred, you got a great laugh at the kidney answer there.
I should have said...
But so far,
on
it hasn't occurred.
On the assumption that it was the kidneys,
yes.
I assumed she would be taking Pepto-Bismol.
Pepto-Bismol.
Yes. Which is not correct.
Things really worked out well at the office. All morning long, we tested beer. All afternoon, we tested our kidneys.
Alka-Seltzer.
All afternoon we tested Alka-Seltzer. And you?
I said all afternoon we tested potties.
Uh-oh.
You know what that means?
Oh, it didn't I?
All she's got to do is match one, and it's all over. Let's find out what happens here. This is Paula's. Tarzan say, me go jungle wife swapping party. Me swap Jane for blank. See, Tarzan and Jane.
Yeah, I understand.
Okay. Right.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, okay.
What is that again?
Tarzan say, me go jungle wife swapping party. Me swap Jane for blank.
Cute. Me swap Jane for... There are so many choices.
All right.
Okay, okay, hon.
Okay.
Just give me a minute now.
Okay, okay, okay. Now think about this, Paula, and give a response you think will get one match. That's all you have to do to win another game. And here we go. As soon as Charles and Brett are ready. Brett's fooling around up there. What are you doing there, Brett?
Oh, nothing, sweetheart. Just hang on that.
No.
I'm trying to catch up.
All right, here we go, Paula. Tarzan say, me go jungle wife swapping party. Me swap Jane for?
Ape.
Ape. Ape is her answer. All right. Audience doesn't seem to approve of that.
They're cruel.
Hold on.
Yes.
You're going ape, are you?
Yeah, well, you might say. Yes. No. Swap for a swinging pygmy.
A swinging pygmy.
Think about it.
Yes. All right.
All is not lost. Do not give up the ship.
I never do.
Do not do any of that stuff because I believe this is a match. Cheetah.
Now, wait a minute. You got to think about this. Hold on now. They're thinking about it. Cheetah was...
What was cheetah? A person?
That was specific, you see.
Oh, she's not a member of the ape family?
Well, could be a member of the ape family, but you are a specific ape you name. And you don't know if that's the ape that she got involved in.
To confuse it even further.
Cheetah.
Well,
no, she said ape, but not. She was not specific with the ape she named. She did not specifically name Cheetah. What do you say?
Well, we are splitting Cheetah three ways then, because I also thought of the ape Cheetah.
All right. What do you say?
I was going to say swap it for a toaster.
Yes.
But I said Cheetah.
You said Cheetah. Now, the goal is not lost, Paul. You got the weirdo to hear from yet. Who could conceivably say something like ape.
I didn't say cheetah, that would be cheating. It doesn't make any sense, no. Does it?
No.
This does. A kangaroo.
A kangaroo. Terrific.
There aren't any kangaroos in that.
So place. There we are. Game ended in a tie, second time in a row. And we'll have to go to another tiebreaker. I'll get ready for that while you take a look at this. Hello there. Here we go. Now listen. This game ended in a tie, so we have to turn out all the lights. As you can see. Got it. All right, turn them out. Shazam. See? They went out. And push the button here. Reveal another tie-breaking set of questions. Mildred, Allred, you may have your choice of A or B.
Stick with A.
Stick with A. Here it is. Everything all right over here?
Everything. Oh,
yes. Yes. I thought I heard a mouse in the pantry.
No.
Out at the home, two of the old folks got married. They were so old, they didn't leave the church in a limousine. Instead, they left in a blank. That's how old they were.
They were so old, they didn't leave the church.
In a limousine. Instead, they left in a blank.
Yes, sir.
Charles is, I don't know what got into him, but it's the new Charles Nelson Reilly. Well, we're back to the old Charles Nelson. No, we're now Mildred. Out at the home, two of the old folks got married, and they were so old, they didn't leave the church in a limousine. Instead, they left in a...
Ambulance.
Ambulance.
I thought a wheelchair, but...
That lady comes up with some very good original answers, and I hope it will be fruitful for her.
Well, in this case, she pulled herself a rotten apple. She left in a hurry.
They left in a hurry.
Ha! When you get that old, you gotta race it.
Right.
You're not there yet.
Gotta hurry up. All right. Very good, old bean.
But they weren't quick enough. The hearse pulled right up.
The hearse. Popular favorite. Take a bow, Brett. Take a bow.
Got the popular favorite.
Spelling doesn't count.
Spelling doesn't count. No. You're a brilliant director, so spelling doesn't count.
It's another match.
Mildred Allred is looking for an ambulance, Nancy.
Isn't she well?
No.
This is a little distasteful, but I said the same thing Brett did. They left in a hearse.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well,
that's the popular favorite with the audience.
I know.
You're really on the beam
it's
there.
It's very sad, though.
Yes, it is sad. Well, some of the questions are sad.
Well, yes. Some of the answers are even sadder. Go ahead.
There were two of them, actually. His and...
Hers.
Yeah.
You want gems? Go to Africa.
Right. So they were sold, they didn't leave the church in a limousine, and said they left in an ambulance.
At least they went together. In a hearse.
In a hearse.
I thought she said tandem.
You thought about, you didn't want to say hearse.
I didn't want to say
well, don't
old
you know
people just getting married going off in a hearse.
Yeah. Yeah, it's kind of dumb.
I'm getting there.
Oh, you're getting
there. Who is it?
Not in my eyes, you're not. All right, Paulie, you ready? Here we go. When Frank found out his wife was coming to the office, he quickly hid his new secretary in the file cabinet, and he filed her under V for blank. V. That's V for blank. The letter V near the end of the alphabet there.
What is it again?
There it is.
What's Frank about his wife coming?
V for...
Oh!
All right. Okay. Well, now that you got to let us in on it, write it down on the card and let us all in on it. Don't just sit there and laugh.
Oh, I just, well, it just... Okay, this okay. Isn't my first choice.
Right, so you ready? When Frank found out his wife was coming to his office, he quickly hid his new secretary in the file cabinet. He filed her under V for...
Virgin.
We are looking for a virgin. Show me a virgin.
Got him. Lightning should be hitting him.
Put down that lightning bolt. We're only kidding.
He filed her in V, being a nice poison, for verboten.
V for verboten. What do you say?
Well, I was trying to match because what I started to say was he filed her under V for wait until later, but I realized that's not it. So he filed her under very often.
Very often? Oh. How nice for all concerned. Charles?
Virgin.
Virgin wins the day. What the rest of you have? Did it again. Well, Mildred, you're a nifty lady.
Thank you.
It was a pleasure to meet you.
It's been a joy to be here. I've enjoyed it.
Well, I'm glad you had a good time. We're going to have a lot of gifts coming your way. Thank you very much.
I said I was going to kiss every man, but I didn't.
Now, while we're spinning her off, we're going to spin some messages just for you. Pay attention now. Here we are. Paula Miller's up here for the second time. She went all the way the last time, won the entire ball game, $5,600. She's picked up another 100 now, has 5,700, and could go over 10,000 if she goes all the way again. You ready?
I'm ready.
We polled a recent studio audience, Paula, and we got their best response to this. Blank print. Now remember, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it, $250 if you hook up with that middle one, and $100 for the bottom one. Now, whom do you call on?
Richard, please.
Fingerprint.
Fingerprint.
Charles.
Out of
print, okay.
Brett?
I don't think that's...
She's thinking.
Here's a good two.
No. Oh, no, that's nice. Blueprint.
Blueprint is one. Fingerprint another. And out of print is a third. Now, you might have a better idea and may want to reject all those. Have you thought about it?
I thought about it. I'll take finger.
You'll take finger. Okay. She says she'll take finger. print. Let's find out if fingerprint is up there, and if it is there, where is it? That is the question, my friends. Let's begin down at the bottom, as we usually do, and reveal the $100 response. Blueprint is the answer that Brett gave you, right? Okay. Let's see if we got a finger under the $250 response. Yes, we do. Congratulations, Paula. Another $250 for you. All right, now you got $5,950. What do you think's under the big one? Newsprint. Oh. No, newsprint. The audience thinks it's out of print. No anarchy, please. Now, stop. They say it's going to be newsprint. Slide it, Earl, please. Newsprint is right. Very good, audience. You're okay. Now, listen, you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $2,500. And to collect, remember, you got to match one celebrity exactly. Very snappy over there. That's right on the ball. What do you say? Who do you want over here?
Richard, please.
You want Richard? Okay. Now, Richard, here it is, worth $2,500 to this lady. The last blank. The last blank. He made up his mind very quickly. Now we ask you to make up your mind and give us an answer, which will match his, and if your ESP is as good as it was last time, you'll pick up another bundle of money here. What do you say, the last?
Time.
The last time. The last time. All right. You don't like that? Wait a minute. Why? What would your second choice be?
The last picture show.
The last picture show. What would your third choice be? Can't get any more ideas. All right, Richard, she says the last time will match you for $2,500.
Now, this is the last mile or the last supper.
The last mile or the last supper. Okay. Well, Paula, you picked up a little more money here, another $350. You're up to $5,950, and you're going to meet another player. Let's welcome Susan McIntosh.
Hello, Susan.
Hi. There you go. Now, we'll find out a little bit about Susan McIntosh.
Okay. I'm married. I'm an accountant for a clothing manufacturer here in Los Angeles.
Yeah?
I have a cat, and I'm a grandmother.
What? You, young lady like you, a grandmother?
Yes. Well, it's my husband's daughter's child.
I see.
But she's my grandchild.
Yes, indeed. Well, good luck to you here. And let's begin by asking you to make a selection. You can have A or B, Susan.
B.
B it is. Ready? Here we go. Bernie the Butcher said to his customer, "Hey," says, "lady, I'll tell you why this ground meat is so unusual. You see, I couldn't get my regular meat, so I ran my blank through the grinder."
Thank you. No, it's all right.
It's all right,
yeah,
now?
It's fine. Thank you.
Okay. How are you?
Very well, thank you. How are
good.
You?
Good. Lady, I'll tell you why ground meat is so unusual. You see, I couldn't get my regular meat, so I ran my blank through the grinder. All right. Whoops, there. Quickly now. Right. Okay. All right.
Same.
Now, Susan, Bernie the Butcher said to his customer, he says, "Lady, I'll tell you why this ground meat is so unusual. You see, I couldn't get my regular meat, so I ran my blank through the grinder."
Dog.
Dog it is for her. What do you say, Avery? She said, "I ran my dog through the grinder."
Well, was I close?
Cat.
Cat.
Sorry. It's cats and dogs. What do you say?
Well, I've learned to get it together. I said,
word.
German Shepherd or dog.
Got it together. One for Susan. What do you say, Charles?
Dog.
Dog, it is.
That's how bad he's right.
Okay. Susan now has two. Nancy?
The Humane Society will hate me, but I said dog.
Yeah, that's the answer. Three for her.
I couldn't risk Betty White. I said wife.
Wife.
Betty White would be
oh, yes.
If I wrote dog.
Wrath would have been terrible. What do you say?
Her chair is vibrating.
It is vibrating, right. Yes.
But I said cat.
Cat, anyway. That's three for her. That ain't bad for a first-round question, is it? Now, Paula, yours will come later. Right now, this is coming your way. Got to stop right here in the middle of round one. That's three for her. Yours will happen the next time we get together. Thank you, ladies. And I thank you all. You were just grand.
No, thank you.
Yes, and I'll look forward to seeing you next time we get together here on Match Game 76. Gene Raper here. Goodbye.
There are so many choices.
All right.
Okay, okay, hon. Okay. Just give me a minute now.
Okay, okay, okay. Now think about this, Paula, and give a response you think will get one match. That's all you have to do to win another game. And here we go. As soon as Charles and Brett are ready. Brett's fooling around up there. What are you doing there, Brett?
Oh, nothing, sweetheart. Just taking a little nap.
Oh.
Trying to catch up.
All right, here we go, Paula. Tarzan say, me go jungle wife swapping party. Me swap Jane for...
Ape.
Ape. Ape is her answer. All right. Audience doesn't seem to approve of that.
You're cruel.
Hold on.
Yes.
You're going ape, are you?
Yeah, well, you might say. Yes. No. Swap for a swinging pygmy.
A swinging pygmy.
Think about it.
Yes. All right.
All is not lost. Do not give up the ship.
I never do.
Do not do any of that stuff because I believe this is a match. Cheetah.
Now, wait a minute. You got to think about this. Hold on now. They're thinking about it. Cheetah was...
What was Cheetah? A person?
Is that not a cheetah?
That was specific, you see.
Oh, she's not a member of the ape family?
Well, it could be a member of the ape family, but you are a specific ape you name. And you don't know if that's the ape that she got involved in.
To confuse it even further.
Cheetah.
Well,
no, she said ape, but not. She was not specific with the ape she named. She did not specifically name Cheetah. What do you say?
Well, we are splitting Cheetah three ways then, because I also thought of the ape Cheetah.
All right. What do you say?
I was going to say swap it for a toaster.
Yes.
But I said Cheetah.
All right, now, we'll tell you what happens when we have a tiebreaker question in a moment or so, but right now, we've got this for you. Ready?
Oh, it is.
Here we go. I'll blow the fuse here and get rid of the lights and push this button. Reveal one tie-breaking question for each of you ladies, and the one who's matched the most celebrities will be the winner. Mildred, you may have A or B.
A, please.
A. She's been sticking with A because that's A for all.
Problem.
You have a problem? That's what everybody keeps saying.
It's raining all over my box here.
What? Yeah, look at all that stuff.
I don't know what it is, and every time I look down at my notes, it's got a wet on it.
Really?
They oiled the fan.
They oiled the fan?
Could I have an umbrella, please?
Yes.
What?
It is.
Oh, no, there's
I
a
know.
Dog
out
it's
there.
Terrible.
It's not paper tray.
Yes. You want to sit over there?
Wow.
Okay.
She wishes she had
sit right over there. Okay, right. I'll sit here. All right, here we go. At Consumer Reports, Herman said, things really worked out well at the office today. All morning long, we tested beer. Then all afternoon, we tested blank. I'm watching. All right. Okay.
So wait a week.
All right. We'll figure out what that is, Joyce. We don't want you to be uncomfortable.
It's very dramatic, though.
Yes, it is. Yes.
I think it's exciting.
All right, here we go, Mildred. At Consumer Reports, Herman said, things really worked out well at the office today. All morning long, we tested beer. Then all afternoon, we tested blank.
Our kidneys.
You drink a lot of beer.
You said cheetah. Now, the goal is not lost, Paul. You got the weirdo to hear from yet. Who could conceivably say something like ape.
I didn't say cheetah. That would be cheating. It doesn't make any sense,
no.
Does it?
No.
This does. A kangaroo.
A kangaroo. Terrific.
There aren't any kangaroos in that.
So place. There we are. Game ended in a tie, second time in a row. And we'll have to go to another tiebreaker. We'll get ready for that while you take a look at this. Hello there. Here we go. Now listen. This game ended in a tie, so we have to turn out all the lights. As you can see. Got a tie. Turn them out. Shazam. See? They went out. And push the button here. Reveal another tie-breaking set of questions. Mildred, Allred, you may have your choice of A or B.
Stick with A.
Stick with A. Here it is. Everything all right over here?
Everything. Oh,
yes. Yes. I thought I heard a mouse in the pantry.
No.
Out at the home, two of the old folks got married. They were so old, they didn't leave the church in a limousine. Instead, they left in a blank. That's how old they were.
They were so old, they didn't leave the church.
In a limousine. Instead, they left in a blank.
Yes, sir.
Charles is, I don't know what got into him, but it's the new Charles Nelson Reilly. Well, we're back to the old Charles Nelson. No, we're now Mildred. Out at the home, two of the old folks got married, and they were so old, they didn't leave the church in a limousine. Instead, they left in a...
ambulance.
Ambulance.
I thought a wheelchair, but...
Here you will.
She said our kidneys. Well, that's very good.
Well, it's...
I don't know if these people are going to be that logical.
It's clinical.
Yes, it is clinical. What do you say, Avery?
Well, I got a little more specific.
What do you
mean,
say?
I mean, a little more general. The John.
The John.
No good, though, babe.
No, that's not it. What do you say? She's looking
well,
for a kidney.
You've got to have them before you can test them, don't you?
Right.
Well, I said the lady and gentleman's toy.
Okay.
But that's not a match,
no,
I
it isn't. We're looking for kidneys
well,
here, one or two.
I think it's snowing over my seat.
That's because you're higher up.
Burps.
We tested burps. Well, Mildred, you got a great laugh at the kidney answer there.
I should have said,
but
John,
so far,
on the
it hasn't
assumption
occurred
that it was the kidneys,
yes,
I assumed she would be taking Pepto-Bismol.
Pepto-Bismol.
Yes. Which is not correct.
Things really worked out well at the office. All morning long, we tested beer. All afternoon, we tested our kidneys.
Alka-Seltzer.
Alka-Seltzer. All afternoon we tested Alka-Seltzer. And you?
I said all afternoon we tested potties.
Potties. Uh-oh.
Not
you know what
match
that means?
Oh, didn't I?
All she's got to do is match one and it's all over. Let's find out what happens here. This is Paula's. Tarzan say, me go jungle wife swapping party.
Oh.
Me swap Jane for blank. See, Tarzan and Jane.
Yeah, I understand.
Okay. Right.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, okay.
What is
that
again?
Tarzan say, me go jungle wife swapping party. Me swap Jane for blank.
Cute. Me swap Jane.
Get ready to match the stars. Avery Schreiber. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Nancy Kulp, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Bulifant as we play the star-studded Big Bunny Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Reber.
Hi, John Nelson. How are you?
Good. Thank you. That's a lively bunch, and we hope you're feeling lively, too, today. And if you're not feeling lively, these people will liven up your day.
No, no.
There you go. What was that?
I could do that. I wouldn't mind it.
I wish you'd say something funny.
Oh, there he is.
Hello.
Are you ready? Good.
Yes, of course. What, for what?
Well, I think we ought to remove the dry cleaning.
The
dry cleaning tag should be tucked
very
in.
Cruel of
that's
you.
Right.
That's what I thought. She has a screw loose.
Well, at least I have it.
That's right.
Now
let's say
what will I do
people
with it, Richard?
Paula Miller and Mildred all red. There. These two ladies are very... matched all six celebrities on one question, didn't you? Now, she's a current champ. She's got $5,600, and she's being challenged by a very able game player, Mildred Allred.
Thank you.
From, I forgot where you're from.
Ventura,
right. You own that big freeway, don't you? Yes.
Wish I did.
You do.